Rich Minds, what's up? Welcome back to your channel, The Rich Mind. Mind rich, to hum rich. So many of you guys must be new to trading or must be trading for some time. So I'm sure you must have heard the term short selling, where you can profit when the price of the stock is falling. So there must be one question which must be lingering on your mind. Can we sell the stock in delivery or can we sell the stock for long term? Watch this video till the end and I will answer all your queries revolving around short selling. And for the loyal rich minds, I have a bonus tip waiting for you at the end. Let's begin. So before we begin, I want you to make sure that you follow me on Instagram and Twitter for more rich content.
Alright guys, so let's begin from scratch and first understand the two positions that you can take in the market, one being intraday and another being delivery. Okay, so this is our area of focus. So when you initiate a buying position, first we'll understand how buying positions take place in intraday and delivery. So when you initiate a buying position in intraday, basically you now have an obligation to sell that stock on the same day before the market closes. Whereas in delivery, for people who don't know what a delivery position is, it essentially means that you pay the entire amount of that stock and you can take that stock home. Basically, you can keep it in your DMAT account for whatever time you feel like. So since you can keep it for whatever time you feel like, there is no obligation by the exchange for you to sell your stock, like you have an obligation in intraday to sell it on the same day. So no obligation to sell. Since in intraday you have an obligation to sell on the same day, your broker gives you a leverage of around about 10 times your capital. So what I mean by leverage of around 10 times is, let's say you have a capital of 1 lakh rupees and your broker gives you a 10 times leverage to that. That means you can buy and sell stocks worth of 10 lakh rupees. This only happens because you have an obligation to close a position on the same day. But since there is no obligation to sell in delivery, your broker generally does not give you any leverage and you have to pay the full cash upfront to carry the stocks overnight in your DMAT. Now I hope the buying side of the position is clear. So I'll tell you what happens at the back end. Let's say there is trader A, which is you, and there is trader B. So now trader A has bought some shares from trader B. So both of these traders have two accounts. One is the trading account and another one is the DMAT account. For people who do not know what trading account and DMAT account is, I suggest you watch my share market for complete beginners video, which I'll link in the I button. So what essentially is happening is, money from trading account of trader A is going to trading account of trader B. So money goes from A to B and B has sold the shares to A. So shares come from the DMAT account of trader B to the DMAT account of trader A. Clear, simple transaction. Let me give you a quick recap. So when you initiate a buying position in intraday, you are obligated to sell it on the same day. And since you're obligated to sell it on the same day, your broker gives you a leverage of around 10 times the capital you hold. And in delivery, there is no obligation to sell. Since you're paying the full cash upfront, you can sell it whenever you feel like. Let's say trader A is buying some stocks from trader B. Money goes from the trading account of trader A to trading account of trader B. And shares come from DMAT account of trader B to DMAT account of trader A. Simple? Now let's understand what shorting means.
So before we move ahead, if you like my work and my content, I want you to like it, comment down below, share my videos and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Press that little bell icon over there.
Firstly, let me give you a basic understanding of what shorting means. Alright, so let's say you are of the view that a certain stock, let's say Reliance, is going to fall. So now stock market gives you an opportunity to sell this stock. To sell this stock first at a higher price and buy it later at a lower price, while you make a profit of the price difference. This is what we mean by short selling. Selling first at a higher price in order to buy it later at a lower price. This is known as shorting. Let me give you an example on the chart. This is an example of NTPC. So the price was high. So let's say you have a bearish view. You can sell the stock first at a higher price and then buy it later at a lower price, so that you can profit the price difference. Clear enough? Now let's say you had shorted this stock in intraday, and now since you have profited from this stock, but you still feel that the stock might even go further down, so you want to continue this selling position overnight instead of buying it immediately on the same day. So essentially what you'll have to do is you'll have to short the stock. You'll have to short the stock in delivery. So let us understand what happens when you short a stock in delivery. Let's say in our case, trader A now wants to initiate a short position. In order to do that, he will have to sell the stocks first to trader B in view of buying it later. So let's see what will happen here. Now A will collect the money from trader B's trading account into his account, whereas A now has to deliver some shares to trader B's demat account. So basically, when trader A is trying to initiate a short position in delivery, he now has an obligation to deliver the shares. This whole process of money getting transferred from one trading account to another trading account, and shares getting transferred from one demat account to another demat account, is done via a process known as settlement process. So now this settlement process doesn't take place during the market hours. It takes place once the market has been closed. So when trader A is shorting the stocks in delivery, he is obligated to keep the shares ready in his demat account by the next day. When the next day comes, the exchange will run a check into trader A's demat account, and if they find out that trader A doesn't have shares ready to be transferred to trader B's demat account, then trader A has defaulted on his obligation to deliver the shares. Now what happens is, the exchange holds a auction process which is complex, and the seller who has shorted the stocks in delivery will have to pay a penalty which might be up to 20% to his selling price due to the default of not delivering to his obligations. If that was too quick to understand, let me give you a quick recap of what happens when you try to short in delivery. When you're shorting, you essentially do not have any shares in your demat account, but still you take a short position, and the next day when the exchange runs the settlement process and runs an obligation check into trader A's demat account, the exchange finds out that trader A does not have the shares in his demat account to deliver to trader B. In this way, trader A has defaulted his obligation to deliver the shares. So this matter will be settled via a complex auction process, in which trader A might have to pay a penalty of up to 20% to his selling price. Okay, now you might be wondering upon a question that, Gaurav, since we cannot short the stocks in delivery, how can we short them in intraday? We do not hold the stocks even there, right? So I will tell you now what happens in intraday. In intraday, basically you have an obligation to close your position on the same day before the market closes. So, since you have sold first, you have an obligation to buy the shares back on the same day. Now, since you have an obligation to buy on the same day, you'll have to close your position before the market closes. When you're shorting in intraday, since you have an obligation to buy the shares back on the same day, you'll have to close your position before the market ends. In that way, when the exchange runs the settlement process the next day, neither trader A nor trader B has an obligation to deliver shares or money from their DMAT and trading accounts respectively. So essentially, shorting of stocks in intraday happens before the settlement process begins, and hence there is no obligation even on the seller's part when he shorts the stock in intraday.
So you, my loyal rich minds, here's your bonus tip. Short selling a stock in delivery and defaulting on the same can get you into very big trouble. So my suggestion would be, never short sell a stock in delivery. And if you want to short sell a stock for longer duration, make sure you short the futures contract of that same stock, provided it fits your risk management criteria. That's it for today. I will see you in the next video. Till then, mind rich. Chucky got the sauce, bitch.